Please welcome Glenn Robbins and Dave O'Neill.
This is very exciting. Two of my comedy heroes, happy to have you here. I want to talk about the podcast, but I saw an image of your podcast recording setup. Look at this. Is this a men's shed support group? What's going on?
No, you're right. That's my shed. That's my shed. At one of the many houses I have around the world.
That's the beach one, isn't it? Now, over summer, we holiday near each other and we recorded in Glenn's shed occasionally.
Oh, great.
Normally we're at the pub. We're at the pub today recording it.
At the pub.
Doesn't look like my podcast studio. Right. I don't have a leaf blower and a hammer in it.
I hate people who come in and use those for me.
Sound effects. Yeah.
Oh, wouldn't that be... Yeah. Wow, live sound effects.
Away we go.
So
somehow related, your podcast is called. You two aren't somehow related, are you?
No, we're not related. Okay. No, we've got similarities, though. Both our dads were in the Air Force. We both went to the same teachers' college, didn't we?
Yeah, and at the moment we've both got a nasty rash, which...
Tell us about the podcast. What's the premise of it? Not the rap.
Here's what. It's somehow related. Two things that you wouldn't think are related, but in actual fact are. So we go on a journey to find out how they're related, and at the end, we're helped out by our friend Sam, who tells us what the real answer is.
Yeah. So the first one we ever did was Nazis and Fanta. So, if you don't know, do you want to have a guess or?
I feel like that might be dangerous.
Well, what happened? The Nazis couldn't get Coca-Cola in World War II, so they created Fanta.
They created Fanta.
See, you're interested.
Fanta's
American.
What does this mean?
Well, I'm just also worried about the sponsors.
Fanta was created in Germany. In World War II, absolutely. And also, Pepsi Max was created by Mussolini. I don't know if you know that. That's a joke, everyone. Let's not go into Mellow Yellow where that came from, anyway.
So what would they be the wildest connections you've come up with?
No, I think, we also find out stuff about each other. Like, we did Ina Blyton and nudity. Do you know what the connection between Ina Blyton and nudity? Mm. You read The Famous Five? The Magic Faraway Tree?
Ina Blyton and nudity.
Yeah.
What's the connection?
You don't know?
Destroy my childhood love of Enid Blyton.
You tell
them. Enid Blyton used to like to play tennis in the nude.
No.
Really?
No.
Yeah.
See, again.
What?
See, these are the things you find out if you tune into our podcast. Wow. In fact, it should be a TV show. We should be on this desk doing this show.
Should we trial that as TV? What if we throw one at you
and
you see if you can figure out the connection?
Oh, here we go.
Okay, we'll make it a bit in-house.
Is it something... just go for it. We're not experts. We don't pretend to know it. We don't always get it right.
That's the joy.
Okay, fire away.
No, maybe the wrong answer's better than the right one.
Yeah.
Where we go?
Sam Taunton, our very own Sam Taunton.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Yes, Sam.
Yes.
And country music.
Your parents were cousins. What else? What do you got? Dad was maimed in an industrial accident on a farm. Think of all the country music cliches, you know, like you play the banjo.
Do I play the banjo?
Yeah,
I don't play the banjo. No.
Okay.
You're related to Johnny Cash.
No, I wish I was related
to Johnny. You've got Johnny Cash hair.
Thank you. That's not it, no.
This is real. Is it real? We're not making this up for the sake of entertainment.
I've got a vague podcast go for. How long have we got to work?
Settle down. It's okay.
It's TV, mate. You've got to move on.
We're doing you next.
Okay. I'm going to say that somewhere in your family tree there's someone who does country music.
That's my dad was actually a country music musician.
There you go.
This is his album here. That's my dad. Straight from the charts. Look at that.
I had that record.
Yeah. I think you and five other people might have had it, Dave. But, he's a country music musician.
Yeah, that was the 90s, wasn't it? Was it the 90s?
Yeah, late 80s, early 90s,
Double denim, too.
Double denim, yeah. I tried to recreate that, but I look like a sex offender, so I can't.
Glenn, I think I saw Russell Coight on a billboard somewhere the other day. Have you talked
to him? You did see it. What's he advertising? You know what he's advertising.
No, I can't remember.
You don't know.
I was driving past.
It's some car or something. Look, I'm doing an ad. Russell Coight is doing it hard.
Look at this.
There he is there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Mitsubishi?
Yeah. He was doing a...
There
he goes, yeah. Okay, it's a car jack. Whatever, get over it. Yeah, there you go. He was doing...
Are you going to fall over or something? Oh,
there you go.
Yeah.
He bangs his knees, and there are nude scenes as well, so you've got to tune in. It's Mitsubishi. Very happy to be involved with the lovely people at Mitsubishi.
Nice car.
It's a very nice car.
Wow, what an ad this became.
Yes. And if you stay with the series, there is a nude scene. Okay. So, well worth seeing.
Have I got anything to plug?
Yeah, go.
Yeah, I was the face of bowel cancer for a while, and you said, this is a true story.
No, it's true.
I had to sit on a toilet and do an ad reading a newspaper. This is...
It was between you and Steve.
Yeah. You were up for that role, but
I missed out.
I reckon your move, Glenn. That's pretty good. Yeah. You can listen to Somehow Related on the iHeart app or wherever you get your podcast. Would you please thank Glenn Robbins and Dave O'Neill? Yeah.